Hi, welcome to this week's wordplay. Normally it's Ocean challenging us, but this week I'll be challenging Ocean to find out if she knows words. Ocean, are you ready to know words?
So it's more like we are challenging each other. Yeah.
Seems to be. Well, I'll be kicking this off, and my first word to you is one of my favorites. Omni-shambles. Do you know what an omni-shambles is?
Oh my gosh, I took the same word.
Then I think that counts for both of us. No.
But you actually should tell the meaning.
Oh, right.
For our viewers.
Well, it's like a shambles. It's like when you make a mess of things, but then you've made a mess of all the things. So everything is in shambles, hence the word omni, hence omni-shambles. It comes from the TV show The Thick of It, featuring Peter Capaldi.
But what was the first thing that you thought the meaning of the word would be?
An all-encompassing shambles, like the surround sound of shambles. So if normally shambles is just from one direction, and omni-shambles is like, you know, surrounding you with shambles.
Okay. I thought it had something to do with the omni van.
Possible, it does tip over.
Yeah.
So this counts as a point for one of each of us.
No, but in a sense, it is connected to an omni van, because usually kidnappers use the omni van to
shambles.
To shambles. Maybe. All right, my turn. Cli-fi. Not sky-fi. Cli-fi. Cli. C-L-I-fi.
Can you use it in a sentence?
This is not spell-y.
It's like Wi-Fi, except for cool clay people. No, I give up.
Not Wi-Fi. It's close to sky-fi.
It's cloud Wi-Fi. So it comes from cloud.
Okay, it's a genre of fiction.
Clomedy? No, I have no clue. I give up.
No. So it's a genre of fiction that deals with impacts of climate change and global warming.
But that sounds kind of non-fictional, because the impacts are very real.
Okay. All right, your turn.
My next word for you is status Freud.
Status Freud.
Status Freud.
Can you spell it?
S-T-A-T-U-S-F-R-E-U-D.
Status Freud. Can you use it in a sentence?
Wait, I'm not supposed to be using it in a sentence. Okay, wait. Have you ever really liked someone's WhatsApp status?
Okay. Is it jealousy for...
Well, what's the opposite of really liking someone's WhatsApp status? Like, what if someone's status gives you a sense of pleasure at their own suffering?
So, it's some sadistic joy seeing somebody else's WhatsApp status?
Yeah, kinda. So it's sort of sadistic joy you get when someone's social media updates make you feel better. It's like Schadenfreude, but social media-ish. I think I kind of gave you that one, but I'll give it to you. You get a point.
All right, next one. I think this is pretty straightforward. It's Zlatan era.
What?
Zlatan.
Yeah.
Zlatan era.
Zlatan, as in the footballer, Z Z.
Yes.
Zlatan era.
Yeah. No, it's one word.
Okay.
It's Zlatan in the beginning with E-R-A at the end.
I take it it's the era of football that began when Zlatan started playing football. You know, you have the Messi era, the Pele era, the Zlatan era.
It has something to do with the footballer.
Oh.
But probably like an attribute of the footballer.
Zlatan Ibrahimovic, right? That's his name?
Yeah.
He plays football.
Swedish footballer.
For the country of Sweden. He's a striker. He shoots goals.
More like a character. Like, what does he like on the field? What does he do on the field? No. But we all know Zlatan for one thing. Even I know. Even I don't watch football, but I know that he's the best of the best.
Debatable. There's many schools of thought. Some say Messi.
But one of his characters, what is he known to do?
I have no clue. I don't watch football. I don't know who he is.
Okay, fine.
But I know who he is, but I don't really know.
So actually, this is given to him as an honor, this word. The Swedish Language Council included this verb's Latin era, which means to dominate.
Oh, okay. So it's a new Swedish word.
Well, it is approved by the Swedish Language Council. So, Slatner as a word, and it came into the dictionary, I think, in 2012.
Right. I'm going to try using that in Counter-Strike, and let's see if anyone gets the reference.
Yeah, it's a pretty cool word. I'm going to use it too.
Okay. I'm hoping you don't guess the next word. May not. Actually, you may. Have you ever been involved in multi-level marketing?
Not really.
Awesome. The word is AMBOT. A-M-B-O-T.
AMBOT. Does it have something to do with robots?
No, but it does have something to do with multi-level
multitasking?
Multi-level marketing.
Multi-level marketing. AMBOT. One person handling all levels of marketing. AMBOT.
Okay, I'm going to ask you, what is multi-level marketing?
Okay. I don't have clarity on that. Probably you'll have to give me clarity on that.
Have you ever had a friend show up from your childhood out of the blue and try to get you to buy a product or sell a product?
Yeah. I mostly buy stuff because, you know, I feel bad for the person.
Hey, if any of you are doing these schemes, this is your target audience right there. Do you give up? Do you concede?
I'm more like Trump. Yeah. I'm gonna concede.
So an AMBOT is short form for Amway bot, and it refers to people who work for Amway and try to get you to buy Amway products, usually as part of multi-level marketing or direct marketing schemes.
Ah, okay. I'm not gonna use that word.
Yeah, you would probably not want to, but you know, if you are selling those products, we now know there's a customer. Maybe you can do an unboxing video.
Okay.
So who wins? What do we win? No one wins.
Thank you for having me in this challenge.
Thank you for challenging me to challenge you in this challenge.
Okay, you can end the video right now.
That's all, folks. Catch us next time for the next episode of Wordplay by other people. Word challenging each other.
Ciao.
Ciao.
Okay.